Hey everyone, in this video, we're going to be walking through how to solve an LU decomposition example by hand. If you missed our previous video on how LU decomposition works, check out the video in the top right-hand corner of your screen now or in the description down below. So, let's get right into this problem. We're asked to solve the following matrix using LU decomposition. In our first steps of solving a matrix using LU decomposition, we do not actually need our coefficient matrix, B. So, we'll just set that aside for later. So, we need to convert this A matrix into a U matrix, or an upper triangular matrix, while recording our applied scaling factors into a lower triangular matrix, which we call L. Getting started, we're going to reduce all elements below our diagonal in the first column to zero. We do this by using the following formula for each row. In practice, it works like this. We want this element to become zero, therefore we say row 2 minus row 1 times our scaling factor of this element over the element of our main diagonal in this column. Therefore, we have row 2 minus row 1 times our scaling factor of 3 over 1. So, let's do the same thing for row 3, and we have row 3 minus row 1 times our scaling factor of 2 over 1. Now, we just need to complete the calculations. You can do this any way you wish. However, just be cautious of sign errors as it can be very easy to make a mistake if you are working too quickly. At this point, we can also begin constructing our L matrix, which looks like this, and we have three spots to fill for a 3x3 matrix. And we actually have two of them already here, as we are going to fill these spots with the scaling factors we've been finding. Alright, so as you can see, we now have our first column just how we want it. Now, let's repeat the same process for our second column. As you can see, there is only one row that we need to conduct row operations on. Therefore, we have row 3 minus row 2 times our scaling factor of minus 2 over minus 7. And again, just go ahead and complete these calculations here. We can also add the scaling factor as our final missing piece of our L matrix. Now that our U and L matrices are solved, we can use the following formula to solve for our constant vector values, which, as we learned in the LU decomposition theory video, we can use to solve for our A matrix. So, as you can see here, once we write out all of our matrices, the only thing we need to do is complete a quick forward substitution to find all of our missing constant values. After solving, you can see that C1 is equal to 1, C2 is equal to minus 1, and lastly, C3 is equal to roughly 1.2857 after truncating our fraction for simplicity. Our final step in completing our LU decomposition example is solving for our unknown x variables. As you can see here, this is done by using backwards substitution, which I will go ahead and complete for you right now. There we go. We have x3 is equal to 0.3214, x2 is equal to 0.14286, and x1 is equal to minus 0.07138. If you wish to validate your answers at this point, you can plug these variables into your A matrix that we had earlier, and this should solve your system of equations. And it does indeed solve our system of equations as expected. Therefore, our solution is correct. I hope that this video helped your understanding of how to solve a matrix using LU decomposition. If you enjoyed, please like, subscribe, and consider checking out our YouTube memberships by clicking that join button down below. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, please leave a comment down below, and I will do my best to address your concerns.